Hey YouTubers, Muskrat Jim here, and today we're at French Fort Cove, right on the highway, so we're getting lots of noise, but there's trails going back into the cove, and it'd be quieter out there, so come along. Well, here's a map of the cove, along with the trails. And right now we're right at the bottom where it meets the Miramichi River. So we're gonna hike on the right hand side, the eastern side of the cove, and follow that yellow trail up to where it bends, and then come right back down again. Now if we look at the legend, the yellow one is called the Fish Quarry Loop. It's about a 45 minute hike. So here are some warnings. Checkout number 4, beware of bears and other wildlife. And proceed at your own risk. Anyway, I've come prepared with some water and a lunch. So, let's take a trail. Some of the landscape here in the park can be pretty steep. I don't know if you can really tell on the camera how steep that is. This is sumac. And as you can see, the leaves turn a bright, bright red in the fall. One of the distinguishing characteristics of sumac is the berry clusters that it has at the tips of its branches. You can make a juice out of those. It's also called staghorn sumac. I think it's because of the shape of the berry cluster. It almost seems like a horn that would be on a bull. This used to be an old sandstone quarry. Closed or went out of business about 100 years ago. Sandstone from here was shipped all the way to Ottawa to build the Parliament buildings. All that's left now just this cliff. An animal the size of a fox could use that as a den. It doesn't look as if there's been any activity in there. No, there's nothing down there at all to indicate that any animals may have used it as shelter. Well, I think I found a private spot where I can sit down and have a quiet lunch. Okay, so I'm going to boil some water for some cup of soup, and I'm also going to throw in some minute rice into the cup of soup just to add more carbs. And then I'll boil some water in this container for some tea or coffee, I'm not sure yet. Let that just sit for a while, let the rice absorb the liquid, and I'll boil some water for some coffee. So I don't think I brought a tea bag today. be a little while longer for that. So meanwhile, I'll just enjoy my lunch. I used an envelope of chicken noodle soup, and turned out to be like 2/3 of a cup of minute rice. So now I have some nice chicken flavored rice. Splash cold water into my coffee just so I don't burn my lips. Cup's quite hot. I'll let that cool off a little bit more. No trip to French Fort Cove would be complete without the telling of the story of the Headless Nun. Back in the mid-1750s, the Acadians were being driven out of their ancestral lands of Nova Scotia, or Acadia, by the British. And some of them escaped northward to New Brunswick and Quebec. Some of them escaped southward to Louisiana and became what's known today as the Cajuns. And some of them went back to France. But an awful lot of them died right on the ships. So for the few that came here, they built a fort to protect themselves from the British. And there was this one nun there, a Sister Marie, and she, being closer to God, people trusted her, whatever, the Acadians put into her possession their valuables, jewelry and whatnot. So Sister Marie, being conscientious, instead of keeping it in her dwelling place or her little shack, she buried it out here somewhere, and only she knew where it was. Well, a little bit later, some sailors arrived to the cove, and they heard about Sister Marie's treasure. So they hunted her down and demanded that she hand it over to them. I imagine they suspected that it was something like a pirate's treasure, you know, like lots of gold coins and whatnot. But I mean, the Acadians were really simple, poor people. They were, you know, they were farmers and that sort of thing. They wouldn't have had a whole lot of gold or jewelry or whatever. So they were modest people. Anyway, getting back to the story. Sister Marie refused to give it to them, just utterly refused. And so they beat her to a pulp, and legend has it that they cut off her head. Ever since then, a story has been going around that she roams these woods at night. Some say she's looking for her head, but I don't think so. What would she need her head for? I think what she's doing is she's protecting her treasure. Whether the story is true or whether it's just somebody's imagination, the story's been going on around here for about 200 years. To the best of my knowledge, there hasn't been any recent sightings of her. The park is pretty well closed in the evenings anyway. During the summer months, there's a tourist attraction, and what it is, it's a walk through the cove being led by an older woman that's dressed up as a nun, and she's telling the story of Sister Marie. And then there's some other actors that come out of the woods and, you know, make a fuss and everything. And it's a tourist attraction. It's local folklore. Now, there's a couple of guys here on the river that made a video of that tour. And if you'd like to see it, just click up this link right here. And those boys, they're a couple of funny guys, really. And if you watch it, I'm sure you'll enjoy it. Anyway, I'm going to finish drinking my coffee. So cheers to you. It's been a wonderful day out here. I'm just going to clean this up and head back. And if I happen to see the Headless Nun, well, I know I won't see her because, one, it's like 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And two, yeah, I don't really believe it. Anyway, if I see anything interesting, I'll turn my camera back on. But until next time, this is Muskrat Jim, signing out.